short film with my longtime DP, Andrew Palermo, just as a way to figure out how to get improvisation on screen, which was how we shot 6 years. And Carson and I just fell in love with these characters, and he presented me with a very rough draft the day that I wrapped 6 years' production. We sort of always did first what was on the page, and then...
Yeah, after we got what you wrote on the page, I feel like then it evolved into whatever improvisation or making it more of a voice.
Of what you guys felt comfortable doing.
Yeah, once I feel like Tony and I kind of fell into what our dynamic was, what our relationship was, that kind of found its way into the scenes in a pretty cool way. We were lucky in that a lot of times we were just in a car or places where we could just do longer takes that kind of meandered and see what we found, which was...
10 minute takes of just talking about nonsense.
A lot of it, just, absolute nonsense. But but some of that nonsense, usable in pretty fun ways.
And made it in and are some of my favorite scenes.
I've actually never done a comedy.
What?
So it was really, really fun. I didn't really know what to expect, especially from like my very first big job was, you know, being on The Newsroom with Aaron Sorkin, and you cannot get one word wrong. And this was just so fun and free and loose. If we would go too far off of the script and go in a direction that was a little too insane, we would have the chance to like, at the end, also go back to the original version of the script. Don't you feel like it was like at the end too?
There's a sense of like the nature of being able to collaborate with everybody in the moment and have it feel loose is kind of what to me a road trip is. Like a road trip is an improvised journey, both on process level and in terms of what we're trying to depict. They are very related in that way, which I thought was really cool.
Well, also just the four of you, including Thaisa, you guys just had such great chemistry and became best friends.
Yeah.
And we're all very serious couples now.
Yes. Yeah.
We are all, and not couples plural, we are a couple. Quad couple.
Right.
Not a lot of people think, oh, you know, brown person, lead. This character has no reason to be brown, black, white, anything. And she cast me because she thought I was the best person for the role. I think that's wonderful, and I think that's a testament to how Hollywood should be striving to be.
Getting roles that are coming my way, I'm finding that while I'm still getting a lot of, you know, scumbag drug dealer kind of people,
really?
I'm also getting quite a few sketchy weirdos. So that's, you know, progress. Progress for me,
right?
Which is very exciting, very exciting.
This was by far the hardest film to get made because people were very confused about why I would want to make this movie after the previous two films. It's very easy, I think, especially for female filmmakers, to get sort of trapped in a box of the kind of film that they should be making.
Right,
which is
only
like
about women or...
Only about women, only a love story, only a drama. This breaks all those rules, which is one of the reasons why I really wanted to make this movie. It inevitably allowed me to just try something new, which is, as an artist, what, you know, you don't want to make the same thing over and over again.
Are you still starting that company where you give actors money to direct movies?
Yes,
yeah,
I am.
Great.
No.
What is the company called again? Mommy's Production?
It's called, Why Don't You Try It?
See how hard it is.